I just want to talk a little bit about the theory of the hip before we go to our other table over here to lay it out. I want to talk about where we get the 16.97. So we have this diagonal line here showing the center of the hip, which runs from the corner of the building line up to the center of the ridge where it meets. So I'm going to lay my square on here as a demonstration at 12 inches here and 12 inches here. And you can see the red line runs at that diagonal. Now if I just measure that 12, see right there, 16.97 inches. So that's where the run of the hip comes at 16.97. And that's just because it runs at 45 degrees to the building line. Okay, it's worth mentioning here that the rise is still the same, whether 16.97 of run now is equivalent to our 12 inches of run on the common. So if I was to measure this, we took 12 inches of run, which we can see here by my corner is 12 inches. It's 12 inches of run here to here as well, everything being square. Plumb up from here should be my stand, which I have measured at 2¾ inches, plus my 8-inch rise. So I should see 10¾ inches there if I get it nice and plumb up, and that's what we have. So that's the same coming across here and here.
Okay, back to the layout of our hip here. Here's the math that we did before. So to the building line, we can see that the hip is 30.875, so 30 7/8 long. Plus our projection is 15 5/8. That makes a total of 46.5 inches. So that's the math that we did before. So now let's go over here and lay this thing out. So the red line again is indicating the center. So we have all of those numbers that we have there are theoretical lengths. So I have taken this, found the crown, there's my center line. I'm gonna lay it this way. And I set my square to my 8 17. So that's as close as I can get to 16.97. And I'm gonna put it on here. So I'm gonna draw this plumb line just so that we're aware of what's happening here. So you can see that that's gonna run plumb right through the building. And I've got it right on the end here so I can actually hook my tape there. So this center line right there, that's the theoretical center that we are gonna lay out to. So I'm just gonna hook my tape right on there. And I'm gonna run down on the line length. I have 30 7/8 to the building line. And I have 46.5 to the outside of fascia. Okay, so those two lines I'm just gonna square across right now. We'll come back to them. Okay, so that's a theoretical length. So now what I have to shorten by is half the 45 degree thickness of the ridge. So that all has to happen this way on the level here. So I'm just gonna put my square on here and line it up. I slide along my fence there, it maintains that slope. So I'm gonna pick half my 45 degree thickness of my ridge is 1 1/16. So I'll put a mark at my 1 1/16 and plumb that back up. This line right here, that there is 1 1/16. All right, so I need to square that across, and that point right there that I'm gonna show you, that's gonna be the point of my cheek cut right there. So I have to lay out my cheek now. So since that sits right up in the corner where the two commons meet in our tripod framing, I need to lay this back 3/4 inch this way here, which is 3/4 inch this way and this way, which makes that a 45, but only 45 on the level, and I'll show you what I mean by that. So let's go back here and lay back 3/4 inch and plumb that up. Now just for our reference here, I'm gonna put that on there and say that's 3/4. From there to there. So there it is. Now let's take my speed square here and I'm going to lay that out all the way across. And I'll show you that that's not 45 degrees. So I take my square, put it on there. You can can see it's close, but it's not 45 degrees. The steeper we get, the farther away from 45 degrees that gets. Okay, so I'll have to lay out the other side of my cheek cut now. So I can just square this across here to right there. And since I'm on the other side here, I need to drop a plumb down this way. So there we are, both sides of my cheek cut. This one, I don't have to draw that line on the top there, but you get the idea that comes across this way. Maybe I will draw it anyway. So that's gonna come across to the center here, across there. That's the two points of my cheek cut meet there, and the plumb lines there. That's where I'm gonna set my saw on the 45 this way and cut it off that way. If I was hand cutting that, we would see that's not 45 and I'd have to follow that line all the way down. Sometimes it gets a little really steep up in the top there. We may have to cut that by hand because that is just too much of an angle. On an 8 1/4 skill saw, you can cut at 60 degrees, but if it's over that, then we're not gonna be able to do that. You could use a Sawzall, but that's not gonna be, for me, that's not going to be accurate enough. All right, now let's continue on back down here, and we're going to be laying out our plumb line at the building line. So I'm gonna draw these two plumb lines. Here's our building line. Right there is a plumb line. And I'm gonna come all the way down here. This is the advantage of this fence, right? I can just slide right off the end here, but I keep it in this, the slope that it needs to be. So I will draw my plumb line there. That's my theoretical center of fascia. And that's my theoretical center. That is the length of this rafter at the building line. So we'll have to modify the bird's mouth here. So here's where we're gonna put our bird's mouth. The bird's mouth is gonna carry on this way with a level cut, the seat cut, a portion of the bird's mouth. So we know that at this point, our stand needs to be 2 3/4 because that's what we measured. So let's lay that out on here. So following the slope here, 2 3/4 inches. So I'll draw that level line across there. Now, what's happening here is when this fits up in the corner, right at the building line, the top plate actually goes on an angle like this. So we have a little bit of run right there. We have 3/4 inch of run on the 16.8, for the 8/12 slope that we're doing here. So we better drop this in order for that to fit. Otherwise, this is in the line because this red line is the center line and our jacks will come up to meet it. And if we don't drop this, the jacks will hit here and they'll have to, the theoretical line will cut through this little piece of corner here and hit there. So what we wanna do is just drop this down so that our theoretical line hits there and the center of the jacks will hit in this point above the board here, straight up in the line. Okay, so let's do that drop now. We'll talk about how to do this, how to drop that by theory, drop it by math in the theory portion of the class. So let's not worry too much about that. So at this point here, we wanna go forward 3/4 inch because that's how that has to do with the thickness of our stock here. So I'm gonna draw a line, I'm just picking a spot here, and I'm gonna go 3/4 inch forward here. So this line here is our theoretical line. So our bird's mouth needs to be where it is. So this line right here indicates that this is us coming forward that 3/4 inch. And what I wanna do is measure down here that 2 3/4 inch. Right there, and that line I'll draw on the level across. Now that portion right there is how much I'm gonna drop this, and that will account for what I was mentioning before. So this line we're not gonna cut, but that line we are.
right, let's slide down here to the tail. So at this end here, this would be the very center of the fascia. Oh, I want to talk about modifying the bird's mouth here too in a sec. But right here, let's look at the fascia. So this is the outside of the fascia. So I want to cut this back, shorten it, full 45 degree thickness of the fascia, which is an inch and a half fascia, but on the 45, an inch and a half is stock, is 2 1/8. 1, 2, 1/8. So that's what the diagonal thickness of inch and a half stock is 2 1/8. So I'm gonna draw that plumb up right there. So this line right here, that's the point where our fascia converges. On the outside here, that would be the fascia running this way, and the fascia is gonna run that way. That's the full thickness of the stock if it was sitting right there. So we have to now put a cheek cut on this so that this lines up and everything fits quite nicely down at the end there. So again, 3/4 of an inch of stock this way, 3/4 of an inch that way. This across the cheek cut is going to go over that line, that line that I guessed at right there. Whoops, it's going to come across like that, and this side will come across like this, and I'm going to draw a plumb line down this way here. Are, and that's where that cheek cut's going to come and make that point here. So I mentioned I wanted to talk about modifying the bird's mouth here even further. So when this goes forward that 3/4 of an inch, on the bottom side here, if this was a gazebo or something fancy, or that really the right way to do this thing is like this. I'm going to indicate actually, this thing, this line right here is my center line. So there's my center. As our top plate comes at a 45 degrees to this, we come forward to 3/4 of an inch. That's because this, that's the thickness of our stock. Our stock's an inch and a half, so half the thickness. It's always half the thickness. So if this was wider, then we'd go half the thickness again. So this is half of inch and a half is 3/4. We go 3/4. 3/4 on the level forward, and then we connect those two. So basically what we're putting here, this is a cheek cut on our, the bottom, on the plumb portion of our bird's mouth. So we would cut, put your saw on the 45 and set the depth and cut it down here to create that. And same on the other side, we have to draw the bird's mouth on the other side in order to get that cut here. So now that's only if we got an open cornice and this is visible to below, something fancy like gazebo. Otherwise, really, we're gonna cut that thing square. I don't like setting the depth of your saw real deep and just plowing it up here and then running past. Whoops. That weakens the stand, it weakens everything here. So I like you to cut it, stop, and finish the rest either with a handsaw or a jigsaw. But back to this here, it's a trickier cut here, but it makes a really nice finish. You can look up from below, especially if stock's thicker. You got a nice piece of cedar here and you're doing a good job for a customer, you're going to want to do something like that. So here's a look at the hip installed now. We can see where it is, the center line runs along here, straight up and meets in the center here. That line falls straight through there. And you can see that by the drop that we have, there's our 3/4 that we came forward. You can see where it lines up here and where our original layout line is. And this level across here, you can see that it's touching there, touching on that first jack and touching on all of the commons running down. So we have a nice plane on our roof. Oh, also, at this point, we bring this down. We can see that the fascia lines up by touching on all of our rafters along here. It's a nice straight line.